after the governor's budget cuts and the latest from Saddam Hussein. Here's Pete Cherney with your forecast.
Well, holy cow, things have cooled off quite a bit in the past couple of hours. We're down into the teens in the north and the upper teens and lower 20s in the south. Big old full moon outside. I'll have a lot more weather, Eloise.
Join us for all the details at 11.
Whole wheat, oat nuggets, and pure molasses. Old-fashioned good taste and a new premium bread. Mainly Grange by Nissen. Try it.
It's four big days of savings.
Humongous savings at Levinsky.
Start with Levinsky's super low prices on winter wear for the family.
And take another 50% off that.
Get selected men's, women's, and children's winter shirts, pants, sweaters, and footwear.
By famous makers like Woolrich, Northern Isle, Oshkosh.
Saturday's Classic New England, Ivy, Health Tech.
Nike, Eastland, Dunham, Erica, and more.
Winter wear for the whole family at an extra 50% off.
Start with Levinsky's extra low prices on winter wear.
And take another 50% off that.
Hurry to get 4 days of gigantic savings.
4 days only at Levinsky's.
John Morgan's all right.
Where is he? Dad, they're putting the cast on. They told us to wait out here while it dries. Everything's under control.
Hi.
Hi. I didn't like my chances of finding another ride back from the seminar. Hospital's on the way to my house.
How did this happen?
John Morgan and Roddy were jumping off the steps. Lily told them to stop. I was there, I heard her. You should have seen him, Dad.
Daddy, look, I got a cast.
I can see that.
Isn't it neat?
No, it's not neat. You broke your arm.
You'll be all right. Mr. Bedford?
Yes.
It's a green stick fracture. We'll probably take that cast off in a couple of weeks.
All right, thank you. I understand that you were jumping off the stairs. Is that true?
Roddy made me do it.
John Morgan, we've talked about this before. You blamed Roddy when you released the brake on the car last summer. You blamed Jessica Mathis when the two of you tried to take a kite out in a thunderstorm with a key tied to the end of the string. You've got to learn to think, John Morgan. Think.
Daddy, will you sign that cast? And you too, Miss LaKansas.
Well, did the doctor say it was okay this soon?
Not right now, John Morgan.
I guess I'm too sick to go to school, huh, Dad?
I think you can still manage to hold a pencil in those fingers. Nathan, please give Lily a ride to her house. Francie, John Morgan, come on.
Wait till I show Roddy.
Careful now.
Rain check. Christina, little boys break their arms.
I didn't say anything.
Sorry. Picked this up a couple days ago. Kids.
Gentlemen, we're temporarily tabling the Landis case.
What? Hallelujah.
Fast approaching is the trial date for the Tyrrell Cement antitrust suit. We're up to our ears in free trade infringements. We'll proceed on them.
Forrest, why give up now after all the work we put in? All right, we can't prove Jerry Blount was in the car, but we've still got time. We'll scare somebody up.
It's tabled.
I just don't understand.
Trucks, it's ugly. Nobody's gonna like it. It's controversial.
The truth is, I received a visit from a friend in Washington.
Oh, my God.
Let's just say it was suggested that if we valued our jobs, we'd drop the Landis case.
Washington said that?
I'm still a novice at this political game. Maybe it is better to wait for the winds of change to blow our way again. But one thing I do know, nothing leaves this office. This conversation never took place.
Absolutely.
Lily, you busy?
Just fixing supper for the Bedfords.
Always did like this kitchen. So airy.
Would you like some iced tea?
No, thanks. Lily is Mrs. Greenway.
What about her?
I suggested that we switch to Adolph's for the groceries. She said no. Mead is a longtime friend of the family.
Why doesn't that surprise me? Probably kissing cousins. Why didn't you try telling her she saved money at Adolph's? You're always talking about how cheap the Greenways are. Tell her Adolph gives S&H Green stamps. She gets herself new TV trays.
Oh, you don't know the woman. When she says something in that household, you don't argue with her. I mean, Mr. Greenway looks like a hunchback from Cowan under her. I buy the Greenway's meat at the butcher shop. The deer is delivered. I mean, the few dollars that I spend in meats won't matter.
Sarah, why are you telling me all this?
I kind of feel bad.
It's a personal thing, I guess. All I know is, after the way Mead treated me, I'd drive to Kenya on a mule to avoid spending another penny in his store.
It cost me my job.
Well, maybe now's a good time to find yourself a better situation.
Well, have you told Mr. Bedford yet that you won't be shopping at Mead's anymore?
No.
Raymond is part-time at the mule. We live off the money that I get from the Greenways.
From the sound of it, the Greenways have everything except the stocks and chains. I'm sorry, sir. That's not exactly what I meant to say.
Well, I made it a whole weekend. It's a record for me.
Maybe cold turkey isn't the best way. Christine, I want to apologize for this weekend.
Don't.
No, I realize now I was preoccupied. It wasn't fair to you.
No, I could have been more understanding.
I don't know.
Doesn't it seem to you like we spend an awful lot of time apologizing and excusing ourselves?
No more than any other couple.
It's funny. After all we've been through, I still don't think of us as a couple.
Well, maybe you should work on that.
What I was thinking while I listened to you talk about your job is that maybe we've fallen into a pattern. We only know how to deal with the hard times together. We know how to worry. We know how to conspire. We know how to complain. But what we don't know is how to be happy together.
Well, you haven't made it easy.
This is my fault?
No, but my God, Christine, I don't seem to be able to do anything right lately. It gets exhausting. What can I do or say to make you feel better?
Well, you can tell me, Forrest. Are we a couple? Am I a part of your life? Are we going to get married, and if so, when? You have made me ask you that. Do you know how that makes me feel?
I do see that for us, Christina. But it hasn't been that long since Gwen died. Certainly not as far as my children see it. So we have to give it time.
No. That's what you need. What I need is an answer.
Well, I just gave you one.
Oh, right. And of course, I come out the selfish one, the one who
can't even take pity on your poor children. I am so tired of falling into that damn trap of yours.
What did you say?
Maybe it's time to admit the possibility that you don't see me as a wife. You see me as a mistress.
Now, don't tell me how I see you. The way you're talking now makes me feel you don't really understand how marriage works.
I think I understand how your marriage works. Forrest, I don't want to do this anymore.
You can't mean that. Look, I know this weekend didn't go the way we wanted.
No, I think it went just the way we wanted. I think we need these disruptions to keep us from looking at the truth.
You're upset now. I understand that. But let's not lose sight of the real truth. We do love each other. We enjoy being with each other. You don't? You don't enjoy my company anymore? My God. John Morgan, are you trying to break the other arm?
Will you sign my cast now? Nathan did, and so did Francie and Lily.
Okay.
Not there. There, next to that stupid flower Desdemona Franks drew on there.
Mr. Bedford?
Yes?
I wondered if I might have a word with you.
Isn't it time for you to put your pajamas on?
Professor, I've been doing the grocery shopping at Adolph's. I switched for Meade's. I felt that I had to.
We've always shopped at Meade's. My mother bought from his mother.
I know that.
So what's the problem? Quality gone down?
Meade is simply not very nice to people.
To all people or just certain people?
I mean to colored people, sir.
I've told you, you're in charge of the household, Lily. You do an excellent job. Shop where you wish.
Mr. Bedford.
Morning, Mr. Barnett.
When's the last time you checked your fan bill?
Oh, it's all right.
Sounds loose to me. You had a date set for me to testify yet? I don't mind admitting that I'm nervous, but the sooner we get this trial over with, the better. That fan belt's shut, all right. I'll get you a new one. On the house.
We're not going forward with the trial. I'm afraid it's been put on the back burner for now. I'm sorry.
Damn those Washington bureaucrats. Damn them to hell. You give them what for? I bet you did. Lousy, mealy-mouthed, chicken-hearted pencil pushers.
It was my decision.
You don't have to cover for them, Mr. Bedford. You don't owe them that.
It was my decision. It's a matter of timing. When the moment is right, then we'll go after those men.
And when will that be? Judgment Day? When there's a colored queen of England? You've got no idea what this cost me, do you?
I know how frustrated you must feel.
I'm not frustrated, I'm mad! I risk my family, my children, damn it! What am I supposed to think when those cracker bastards come after us now? What a pleasure it is to die for nothing?
Curtis.
Mr. Barnett will do.
I've told no one about this.
I've told my wife. You can bet the whole neighborhood knows.
Believe me, Mr. Barnett.
Believe you. That was my problem to start.
You won't believe all the changes unfolding during the JCPenney White Sale. Now these popular 100% cotton towels are three for $9.99. Save $15 to $50 on our comforters and bedspreads. Then pick up some home collection sheets for $3.99. Save on everything from sheets to shams to shower curtains. So hurry to the final week of the JCPenney White Sale and see how the savings shake out.
JCPenney.
When your sinus and nasal congestion feels this bad, what can you do? Last year, you wanted to call the doctor. Last year, you wanted a prescription. But this year, Tavis D in its full prescription strength is available without a prescription. Just one tablet helps relieve 12 hours worth of painful congestion and sneezing.
Guess what? I'll be there after all.
Tavis D. One tablet, 12 hours, and now no prescription.
Could you pass me some more of those crunchy little oatmeal cookies?
You mean the Cracklin' Old Brand cereal?
Whatever. Tastes like oatmeal cookies to me.
Pardon?
Nothing.
Okay, so it does taste like oatmeal cookies.
Thank you.
But...
it's a cereal!
Oatmeal cookies!
Crunchy baked whole grain oats and a touch of brown sugar make Kellogg's Cracklin' Old Brand...
taste like oatmeal cookies.
But it's a cereal.
He had the power to penetrate the criminal mind.
Tell me more about the dream.
But when a murder suspect gets inside his mind...
you feel the same connection, I know you do.
What he discovers...
you are crazy.
I am not crazy!
...could cost him the only thing he loves.
Oh, my God.
Mind of a Killer, a world premiere NBC Monday.
Mr. Bedford. Do you have the additional evidence that will place Jerry Blount in the car?
Yes, I do. I have the sworn statement of proposed witness Curtis Barnett.
Is this witness's relationship to the proposed proceedings?
On the night in question, this witness sold gasoline to Guilford Plaquemine. He will testify that there were three men in the car, the third man being Jerry Blount.
Gentlemen, stenographer... would you all wait outside, please?
Buck up, Brad.
Tonight, we have an inquiry from the community. With us is Mr. Douglas Hawthorne, the owner and proprietor of Jimmy's Fine Dining here in town, and the barbecue shack out on Route 9. Mr. Hawthorne. Thank you, Reverend. I buy my restaurant supplies from Gus Mead at wholesale, out from his outlet in Lakeview. And he gives me a good price. But since there's been some activity putting the squeeze on him, he's putting the squeeze on me. Now I'm having to pay damn near retail. Now I want to know what's going on out there. Brother Hawthorne, the truth is I'm not as well versed on this issue as I'd like to be. It began grassroots from within our ranks. I believe Sister Harper is the one you want to talk to. Sister?
Mr. Hawthorne, all I know is when I shopped at Mead's, I couldn't help noticing we colored were only welcome there as long as we're spending white people's money.
Mrs. Harper, do you know what it takes to become a colored businessman in this environment? And if you don't mind my saying so, a success? We as a people have got to work twice as hard to get half as much. Now, I support the civil rights movement, but you ask yourself, what do you think would happen if a businessman like me went belly up?
Mr. Hawthorne, I wonder if you've been in Mead's store. If you walked up to the cash register to buy your groceries.
No, Mrs. Harper, I have not.
It's a humiliating experience. Mead has always been rude and callous to us. My friends and I decided enough is enough. The boycott just kind of spread from there.
Well, it's easier for you to think that sending this message to Mr. Mead is worth my financial risk.
Other people are at risk, too. I didn't know what my employer was going to say about all this. People have been threatened with losing their jobs. We want Mead to integrate his store.
Mrs. Harper, I was going to come in here to urge moderation. But I can see you're sending a message that we are forced to be reckoned with. I'll just have to find me another supplier. That's all there is to it. And I'll eat the overage.
Mr. Bedford, the phone has been ringing off the hook with reporters wanting to know if the indictment came down.
It did.
Congratulations. Way to go, boys.
I know it's late, but can you hang in a little? I'm going to want to dictate a press release.
Sure.
What's this? Open it.
This should come in handy.
It's standard naval issue for us.
The salesman said it was flotsam from the PT-109. It was my idea, Forrest.
Is this from friend or foe, Brad?
Well, I got it some time ago as a joke and just never got around to giving it to you. And this morning, I put it on your desk as a peace offering. But right now, in all earnestness, you might need it, Forrest. Not to mention that if you go down, we'll go down with you.
Due to budget restraints of the department, we could only afford one of those.
Don't worry. When the time comes, I'll share.
A strawberry, blueberry star. Oh, they're not stars shining on high.
What's the matter?
I just hope Reverend Henry doesn't expect me to speak again like I did tonight.
Why not?
I'm not comfortable standing up in front of a group like that and talking.
You did fine. I'm the only one saw your little hand shaking there.
I don't like being pulled to the front.
I disagree. I believe that you do.
Even if that's true, I don't like what's happening because of it. I know that the boycott we started is a good thing. I want it to go on and succeed. This is difficult. Don't take this the wrong way. I don't want people to look to me. I'm not the leader.
You started it.
But I didn't mean for... It's gotten big, complicated. I'm more comfortable in the background.
Aren't we all?
Sarah came to the Bedfords the other day when I was working. She said her boss told her she had to shop at me so she'd lose her job. What right do I have to tell her what to do? She has children. Her husband has a hard time finding work. I don't know if I'd do any different in her situation.
What right do you have to stay silent during these times? You have a strong voice, Lily. Use it.
I'm not sure I'm ready to do what's required of me.
When this mess is over, a lot of your friends will decide they don't like you. But they'll thank you. And I'll like you.
When I search my heart, I have to admit it's not the ideas I live by that keep me going, though my life would be less without them. It's the people, the friends, the knowing that there's someone there when you feel alone, the human hand on mine, the smile that makes me smile.
Up next, Maine reacts to the prospect of what may be the worst cut yet. The latest from the posturing Saddam Hussein. Britain bans fishing anywhere near the grounded oil tanker. Dale Duff and Jess Solari have high school basketball highlights from around the region. And Pete Cherney has your weekend outlook. All the details next.
Just off the coast of Alaska runs some of the world's finest salmon. And when they do, Jim Herford knows they won't wait for a sinus headache. Thankfully, there's Tylenol Sinus, with maximum strength decongestant for the pressure, plus something no other sinus medicine has, Tylenol Pain Reliever, the one that's cared for more Americans, including the guy who has to bring home the catch. Tylenol Sinus, the strength you need from the name you trust.
Yep, I'm part of the management team now, Mama.
Oh, baby, I'm so proud of you.
It's only afternoon.
But still, it's a promotion.
I gotta get back to work.